Good evening, everyone. Right at the outset, I must congratulate the organizing committee of this conference, of Mahaniyopan, for organizing such a nice conference. The venue is really very good. The scientific program has been prepared very well, so I appreciate, rather everyone has appreciated. And as you had seen throughout the day, the speakers, they have really taken you through various topics. And from the more intensive to some little less intensive or something which is very new, I will be speaking about quality improvement in neonatal practice. Before I speak, let me ask, how many of you have done quality improvement workshops or work, are working in quality improvement in NICUs? So this has been, as you can see, this has been a new entrant in neonatal practice. Though across the globe, in Europe or the Western countries, this is a quite an old thing. Improving the quality, giving quality of care, patient safety. If you look at the Vermont-Oxford network, since 25-30 years they are maintaining that collaborative network and they are working on this. But if you see, this is an in thing now. And none of the neonatologists or people who are caring in the ICU, whether it is NICU, pediatric ICU or adult ICU, they can overlook this, they cannot overlook this quality improvement approach. So my humble request to all of you would be to let us look at what it is and whether it really works. Because if you are reading in the social media or maybe on the sites of the government has taken this in a big way, quality improvement in SNCUs. Though in Maharashtra it is yet to be implemented, in some of the states already they are doing, through the government, they are doing quality improvement work in district SNCUs. So I think it is at the right time, rather the time is overdue, long overdue, and we should be looking at what it is and try to acquire the methodology and implement, start using it in your practice. As we know, the medical culture, rather the practice culture in present scenario is still that we feel that we are doing a standard work, which is always into inverted commas, and which is questionably evidence based. And most of the work which even today it is done in the ICUs, it is rooted in silos. They are solo setups, very small setups. There is a lot of resistance to teamwork. And unfortunately, the care even today is provider centric rather than patient centric. And there is always a lack of sense of urgency in any ICU, or for that matter, in any hospital. The biggest weak link is emergency care, if you see. And the common perception of quality of care, which even I had till last 3-4 years, was state of the art technology and gadgets, big setups and high cost of care. And hence, when we were exposed to this concept of quality of care, then the first time, I think Dr. Kedar had come to us to mention that, sir, we will start doing some quality improvement work. So I just laughed it away. I said, I'm working in a public hospital, such a huge hospital. What am I to do with the quality and the quality of care? And then we had the sensitization interaction, and then our journey started, which I will take you through briefly subsequently. WHO defines quality of care as the care is quality of care is the extent to which healthcare services provided to individuals and patient populations improve desired health outcomes. So every word is important. And in order to achieve this, the healthcare must be safe, effective, timely, efficient, equitable, and people-centered. So six characteristics are there. So the care has to be safe. That means delivering the healthcare that minimizes risks and harm. It should be effective. Providing services based on scientific knowledge and evidence-based guidelines. It has to be timely, that means reducing the delay, efficient, delivering healthcare in a manner that maximizes resource use and avoids waste. It has to be equitable and it has to be people-centered. So all these six things have to be there to say that it is a quality care. Then comes the quality improvement. So how to improve the quality? It is the combined and unceasing efforts of everyone involved in providing the health care to make the changes that will lead to better patient outcomes, that means the health, better system performance, that is care, and better professional development, that is learning. So all these three together, they are the cornerstones of quality improvement. The central law of improvement states that every system is perfectly designed to achieve the results it achieves. So changing the outcome, it requires changing the system. But remember that while every change does not lead to improvement, improvement needs change. So if you want to improve, you will have to need to make changes. But unfortunately, the scenario is this when it comes to quality improvement, as it has been alluded to previously also in our oration also, that we have our scientific understanding has progressed a lot, while the patient care, the actual knowledge which is implemented, it has lagged behind, as there is always an implementation gap. And very often, the quality assurance is confused with quality improvement. Assurance is an accreditation process. There are set standards. Accordingly, we assess the facility, whereas improvement is a process. And most of the time, the quality assurance comes from top down. There is somebody who is monitoring the quality, and then they are assessing the facility. Whereas in quality improvement, everybody who is involved in the care, it partakes in improving the quality. And usually it is the bottoms-up approach in case of quality improvement. At the society level, the quality of care reflects the concerns for cost effectiveness, equal access and equity in service delivery, transparency and extent of out-of-pocket expenditure. Because this is particularly applicable not only in private, even in public hospitals. How much is the out-of-pocket expenditure? Say for example, in my NICU, the baby is admitted in the government. How much he is spending? So that reflects reflection in the society of the quality of the facility. And for improving the quality, there is a model for improvement, whereby we ask what are we trying to accomplish, how will we know that a change is an improvement, and what changes can we make that will result in improvement. And there is a methodology. You have to do this. Actually, it is very difficult to take you through all the aspects of quality improvement in just 20 minutes of a lecture, because there are workshops which last for 2 days, even 3 days sometimes, which train in quality improvement methodology and which subsequently can be applied. And this has been going on across India. So there is a plan, do, study, act, or PDSA cycle, which is problem solving methodology, where the first step is to identify the problem, what is the problem, then second is to analyze the problem, then finding the solution, then implementing the solution, and evaluating the effectiveness of the solutions. When it comes to identifying the problem to solve, usually we look at the data, local data of the facility, and identify the gaps related to the care. Here we look at usually the simple, easy to fix, and amenable to change sort of problems. They should have value for the patient outcomes and does not need any many new resources. Say for example, if I have to look at in my facility, how many babies are on admission are hypothermia, then I will have to have the data, review the data, what percentage of babies they are hypothermia. And then from there onwards, then I try to rectify that issue. And then I decide the project to undertake in the methodology of quality improvement with an aim to improve the outcome. And the aim which is taken it should be SMART. That means it is a mnemonic for specific, measurable, achievable, relevant and recorded and timely. Then subsequently, this is the methodology. I am just brushing through the methodology of the quality improvement because it is very difficult to grasp it in the first instance unless you are exposed to quality improvement methodology. We need to form an aim statement because we will have to undertake a project to see what is happening and try to solve it by using quality improvement methodology. For that, we need to form an aim statement, then analyze in detail as to what are the possible causes of the problem. This analysis also helps us to focus on things that are within our control. This gives an opportunity for everyone to give their insights based on their role in the process, and it helps us understand what is happening in the system at present and thus identify possible solutions. In the methodology of quality improvement, I am not going to burden you with this terminology. These are the terminologies which are used, the methods which are used as to why might a problem be happening. One is fishbowl, then five wires, Pareto principle and process flow charts. This is an example of a fishbowl for improving the kangaroo mother care. And this is also known as root cause analysis, whereby we look at the four factors divided in four. One is policy, then the people, then the procedure and the place. Under these categories, we try to find out under each category what are the problems. Then another way of analyzing it is asking five whys. That means understanding why something is the way it is, like why the baby is hypothermic on admission. So I keep on asking why. Or if it is KMC, why mothers are not giving KMC? Then the example is as it is. They feel uncomfortable taking their gown off. Why? Because the gown opens at the back. So they have to take entire gown, so they feel uncomfortable. So why they have to wear this type of gown? Because that is what store has ordered. Why doesn't the storekeeper order front open gown? Because no one has requested him to do that. And this is actually the project which our people have done. They have looked at various aspects of KMC, and I must say I will show you also the data. That KMC in our unit has really improved very well. You can say that it is really very good in Maharashtra at least. The number of hours per day, the average number of hours KMC is received per baby. So to understand what are the problems, we need to know the process. And where is the problem? So we need to have a process flow chart, where we decide the beginning and end points of the process and identify the steps and then review the chart, whether the steps are in logical order, illogical order, or something is missing. So this is a flow chart for the admission of the baby to the NICU. From delivery is the starting point to the admission to the NICU. So if the baby is delivered, admission is indicated, no, give the baby to the mother for breastfeeding, yes. Then relatives are called and counseled, Then there are these various diamond and the circle and the cloud is used. Cloud indicates that it is questionable still. Then if the relatives are available or willing for admission, no, again we try to counsel. If yes, we send it, to get admission paper. Admission paper is obtained. Labor room staff enters in the record, staff shows gender to the relatives, and the staff takes the baby to the NICU. So these are the steps which are involved in the admitting the baby from the delivery room to the NICU. So I have to chart down every step to identify what is happening, why the babies are getting delayed admission in NICU. Baby is delivered 1 hour back. Why the baby is taking 1 hour to get admitted in the NICU. So we have to chart down the process. And we have to measure also, because measurement only will tell you whether there is improvement or not. There are two types of measurements we do. We measure the processes and the outcomes. Because if you don't measure the process, then you will not know whether the action you want to done is really happening or not. Say for example, hand rub, use of hand rub. How will you know whether the hand rub use is optimum or not? Unless you measure by applying certain sort of methodology. Similarly, for the outcomes, if you don't measure the outcome, how will you know whether the action is really leading to the desired outcome or not? Then we plan the test. This is the methodology. We develop little changes and we test the changes. These are some of the categories of change. Say for example, if you are to improve the knowledge or skills, we have to teach about the importance of skin to skin to keep the babies warm. Eliminate waste like that. There are examples. And this is the plan, do, study, act cycle or PDSA cycle. And this is an example of PMC, how it was used in various steps to improve the KMC. Like in first PDSA cycle, there was a policy communication gap, so policy communication was started. In the second cycle, the mother's education was done. In third cycle, KMC chairs were provided. The fourth cycle, KMC binders were given, but because of that, you can see in the fourth cycle, it has dipped. The rate of KMC has dipped. That is because the binders were quite uncomfortable, so that idea was abandoned. And then we fixed the time slots to adjust to according to the mother's schedule. So that also increased the KMC. And then we developed a KMC designated block, because it is very essential that in KMC type of thing needs a designated block, because that motivates every mother. And then comes the implementing the change and sustaining the change. It requires lot of effort, lot of persuasion on the part of the team leaders and everyone involved. You can see this is the graph of 2018 of our unit. We could maintain the KMC throughout the year, above 7 hours. But there are challenges to quality improvement. The first and foremost is convincing the people that there is a problem and it is relevant to them and the solution chosen is the right one. Second problem is getting the data collection and monitoring. Then excessive ambitions, conflicts in capacities and context, weak leadership and risk of unintended consequences. Remember, in quality improvement, you have to have a strong and passionate leadership. The NICU team leader has to be very strong and passionate. Without that, quality improvement work cannot be taken forward. And remember, the quality improvement is a cyclical process, continuous process and incremental process, and it is primarily internal process driven by the motivated staff. And the most important thing which I feel in terms of quality improvement approach and which I have spoken on various fora is that it empowers the frontline health workers. In our case, the frontline health workers are the nurses. So it empowers them, involves them in the care, and their involvement really motivates everyone. So the four key habits of quality improvement are habit for change, habit for practice as process, habit for collaborative learning, habit for evidence-based medicine. In the end, I just take you through the QI journey of our department. It started in 2017 with the sensitization lecture which I mentioned to. And then we had a workshop with an NQOCL, which is a National Quality of Care Network, hosted by chiefly by Dr. Vikram Datta. And they had come to Aurangabad in 2017 itself. And we are really thankful to Dr. Vikram Datta, Dr. Mehtab Singh, Dr. Kedar, of course, Dr. Sushil, and Sonali Vaid also, Ankur also. So these people have really motivated us in taking up this QI work. And really they were in touch with our all the nursing staff for almost a year, to WhatsApp, to video calling, and they really handheld our unit for improving the quality. Then our three of my nurses, which never happened in the history of GMC Aurangabad, three of my nursing staff, they presented their projects at WHO experientiary workshop in Delhi. To the point that some of my, two of my nursing staff, they were traveling by air for the first time. And it was really, that really changed it. And subsequently, I should say, I think there are 13 nurses which have done TOT from my unit. There are 13 nurses now. And today and tomorrow also, they are going to present 6 projects in Delhi. There is one nursing conference which is being going on in Delhi. So these are some of the posters which nurses they presented. These three were really appreciated. One was KMC, second was use of sterile air, and third was follow-up OPD. You can see the follow-up OPD number has really shot up after the QI project. Because it is not just doing a project, but also making it, changing it into policy. That's 1 second. Then these are other QI initiatives, QI promotion activities. We took it to other departments also in the GMC Aurangabad. We took it into the in-service nursing training, so we trained 270 nurses. We took it to the district SNCUs. We are mentoring 4 districts. So we try to do whatever is possible to spread the QI. And even today there are 2 nursing staffs, they are involved in the National Quality Improvement Program of the Labour Room. You must be aware of Lakshya program. So there are 2 nursing staffs from my unit, they are the national mentors in there. And there is one faculty which is mentor for the Madhya Pradesh. These are some of the useful resources. Those of you who would like to see what is it, how it is done. And this is not just medical college I am telling you. This all quality improvement first initial projects were done in Himachal, in some of the distant sub-centers and BSCs. And they were published in the Lancet and BMJ, I think. So, this has really is changing, because increasingly we find that resources are there, but the results are not coming. There are resources are there in 2 centers, but if 1 center is getting results, other is not getting. There are books also. Remember, in God we trust, all others must bring data. So perhaps by working together, we will someday soon be able to offer our patients the healthcare they expect and deserve. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Deshmukh.
So, I expect that last year only, during our tenure only, we were to do some doing this QI improvement at district SSU in collaboration with UNICEF, state chapter with UNICEF and the NHA. Unfortunately, we appealed and very few took, showed enthusiasm to get involved, because then you will have to spare time. I hope with the dynamism of Sandeep Kadam and Sunil Gavane, they will find more people who are involved and committed in improving the quality. Thank you.